What's up guys, AntsCanada here. Welcome to another AntsCanada video. I'm here in the beautiful Toronto, Canada. I've really missed North America and I wanted to use this morning to go looking for queen ants because I do know that tetramorium queens are flying now here in Canada and around North America. So come join me. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Let's start this. So here I am. It's kind of a suburb. My dog there. I usually go queen hunting in the afternoons, but I wanted to try queen hunting in the morning. Now tetramorium have their nuptial flights really early in the morning. They're early birds. As far as ants go mating, they usually have their nuptial flights at 5 a.m., 6 a.m. around that time. Of course, tetramorium are known as pavement ants because you find them a lot around pavements like this. In the summer, sometimes you'll see masses of them gathering at the sides of the sidewalks. I'm sure a lot of you guys have seen that. And that's what you call a tetramorium war. A lot of times these colonies will come face to face and they'll just come boiling out and have this massive tetramorium war above ground. They're a very aggressive species, but thankfully they're not really dangerous to humans. They do have a stinger, but it's really small. So it usually isn't enough to do damage on humans. Okay, so I see a Camponotus worker there. A lot of you guys email me saying, can you please identify this queen? And a lot of times it's a Camponotus worker. This is Camponotus pennsylvanicus. This is not a queen. The queens of this species are much larger. They have larger abdomens, or gasters, I should say, and much larger thorax, or mesosoma. All right, so I'm gonna continue looking down this sidewalk for queens. Now for those of you who follow us on Facebook, our Facebook page, hey, and I just found a queen. Awesome, right here. I was saying on Facebook, we did a live feed where we live streamed hunting for queens and we found a queen, a tetramorium queen, but the wind blew her away. But I'm not gonna let this one get away. So let me put this down here. Come on. Oh. Oops. Sorry guys. Oops. All right guys, and we have our first queen of the day. Here she is. Tetramorium, easy. Okay guys, so now that we have our queen right there, beautiful tetramorium queen, pavement ant, we have to create a test tube setup for her. So this is a queen I caught a few days ago, and this is your typical test tube setup. It basically requires a water portion plugged in place with a cotton and then another cotton placed here so she can breathe. And then what this does is it creates a very constant environment here, which acts as her claustral cell. You know, it replicates her underground chamber while she's getting ready to lay eggs. And then in a few days, you'll have this, which is a queen, but she's got eggs. You see that there? See that batch of eggs there? It only took her 2 days or a day to start laying, which is great. See those little tiny eggs? She has some in her mouth. Now, of course, there's no way to tell for sure if she's fertilized. But the fact that she's taking care of the brood, like she's got a bunch in her mouth, it is a good sign. Because usually, if they're not fertilized and they lay eggs, the eggs are kind of scattered and she kind of ignores them. but it looks like she's taking good care of these eggs there. Now, typically you want to keep her covered and in the dark, wrapped in maybe a towel and tucked away into your deepest closet or drawer, because you don't want to stress them out too much at this stage. I'm kind of exposing her like this so that you guys can see what it looks like, but if you have a queen, I really suggest you put her away in the dark, because you don't want to stress her out. She might eat her eggs, or she might not lay at all. But I would suggest, if you want to check up on her perhaps once every week. It usually takes about 1 month to go from egg to worker. So in about a month, this queen will have her first set of workers, the nanitics. Now, tetramorium queens are fully claustral, so they don't need to eat during the stage. They have everything they need within them. Her thorax, which housed the wing muscles, she draws her ATP, her energy, and nutrients from those back muscles. And then she creates this self-made nutritious soup, which she feeds to the larvae. And that's how they grow. She creates food, baby food, from her own body, which is really cool. And then when the first workers arrive, you can wait maybe 1 to 5 days, and then you can feed them either a tiny, tiny drop of honey administered by a toothpick, or maybe a cricket leg, something like that. When the workers first arrive, they're still hardening, and they're also still feeding from the queen's self-made soup, so you don't have to worry about feeding them immediately after. All right, and for those of you who need a more in-depth tutorial on how to take care of queens when you first catch them, be sure to watch our Caring for Queens tutorial. And also check out our test tube re-tutorial if you need a tutorial on how to create a test tube setup. Never, ever, guys, fill this with honey water. It's gotta be fresh water. All right, thanks guys for tuning in, and stay tuned for another video. Oh, also guys, be sure to check out our GAN project. For those of you who are looking for queen ants in your city, we're actually selling young colonies with queens in various cities around the world. So see if we are selling in your city. And if you have more queens than you can care for, be sure to join our GAN project, and we can help find people to buy your queens and colonies off you, or you can give them away if you like. All right, guess that's it. Thanks guys, stay tuned for another video. Bye bye. Hey guys, it seems like you guys are really liking these ant videos. Now I've got a question for you. Do you think we should switch from uploading every first and third Monday of the month to uploading every Monday of the month? If enough people say yes, I'll upload a video every Monday. So let me know in the comments section. Thanks guys so much for the support. It's Ant Love Forever. Thanks so much for watching our video. It really means a lot to me. Again, subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to check out our very helpful ant tutorial playlist. It's got tons of very easy to understand ant tutorials on ant keeping. And don't forget to also check out our Solenopsis Geminata playlist.